بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر. الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على رسوله الكريم وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. ما بعد فيا عباد الله أوصيكم وأوصي نفسي بتقوى الله. O servants of Allah, we praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and we send peace and blessings upon his last and final and most noble and most beloved messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I encourage you and I encourage myself to have taqwa of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to glorify Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bit takbirat in the takbirs of this Eid by saying Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. The messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in his sunnah on the way to Eid, he would do the takbirat. In the musalla, as you have seen today, it's the sunnah to do the takbirat. And in his khutbah after the salah, he would do the takbirat. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. To be a constant reminder to us that on this day of joy and celebration, that we don't forget that the reason that we are celebrating is to glorify Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. This day of celebration that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made as an Eid for us, for the Ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the most beloved to him, al-Habib, al-Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We are his Ummah, and he has made from his Sunnah this day of celebration, Eid for us. And the day is a day of joy to remember the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We spent this month in fasting and holding our nufus, ourselves back from eating and drinking and other matters. And we spent our times in the masajid. And we spent our times reciting the Qur'an. And after all this month of all of this hard work, a day of celebration and joy. Eid ul-Fitr, the day of breaking the fast. This whole month was a day that we had to fast. That it was an obligation upon us, even though it was hard. وَهُوَ كُرْهٌ لَكُمْ As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Qur'an, that it is difficult and hard and something that is difficult for you to do. But we have to fast during the month. But on this day, on the day of Eid, it is haram to fast. It is prohibited to fast because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants to show us all the blessings of eating and the food and the sunnah of wearing new clothes so that we know the joy that Allah has given to us and the blessings that Allah has given to us. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Some of the sunnahs of this day is to wear new clothes. To wear new clothes so that we can show the blessings. Allah is showing us that during this month we were holding ourselves back intentionally from the blessings of food and water. We were holding ourselves back, and on this day he's saying, enjoy those blessings. I want you to see those blessings. One day the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saw a man wearing shabby clothes. And he called him over. And he said, or he asked about that man first, and he said, who is this person? And they said, is he poor? And they said, no, he actually has wealth. So he called him over and he said, wear clothes that reflect your blessings, that show their blessings. And then he mentioned, وَأَمَّا بِنِعْمَةِ رَبِّكَ فَحَدِّثْ from Surah Al-Duha. As for the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, make mention of them, show them. So even though during this month we were holding ourselves back from so many things, putting ourselves almost in a state of a monastery, Ramadan is an institution like a monastery. We held back. Many of us might have reduced our work. We reduced our social interactions. We reduced our social media. We reduced listening to things, watching things, interacting with things. We reduced so much. We went inward into almost like a monastery. And we worked on ourselves and we worked on our souls. But on this day, it's the day to come out and to greet our brothers and sisters and to ask forgiveness from our brothers and sisters for anything that we may have done or said towards them. And to remember the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He has given us. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Part of the remembering of the blessings is that we know now how to use the blessings of Allah and to how to have proper shukr of Allah. Pure and proper shukr is using the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to thank Him in His service. In the two surahs that I recited in the salah today, per the sunnah of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Surah Sabbih and Surah Wash-Shamsi wa Duhaha. In both of those surahs, there is a mention about tazkiyatun nufus, purifying ourselves. As almost a reminder to us that on this day of celebration, this is not just a day just to celebrate for the purpose of celebration. It's to remind us of who we are as Muslims, and to remind us of the blessings that Allah has given us, and how we use those blessings. How we use those blessings. During this month of training that we just finished, this month of Ramadan, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allow us to reach the next Ramadan. The Sahaba and the people of the Salaf used to spend the six months after Ramadan being sorry for having missed Ramadan being over. And then the five months before the next Ramadan, looking forward to the next Ramadan. The whole year was looking forward or being sad that Ramadan has gone. And the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to make dua at the beginning of every month for him to reach Ramadan. This is our hallmark month of the year, our holiest month of the year. And in it, Allah, through the immense blessings He has given us, He has allowed us to see what we're capable of. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. He has shown us His blessings on us. And He has shown us what our aspirations can be. He has shown us what we can do. He has shown us, He has proven to us through ourselves that yes, we can give up food and water for 15, 16, 17 hours a day. Not only can we as adults do it, but the thing that amazes me the most is the old people and the very young people. The 7-year-olds who fasted. Raise your hands if you were 7, 8, or 9 and you fasted an entire day. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. This is the blessing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on the ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That even young children can fast an entire day, can go through the whole day fasting. When adults will come up to you and say, I can't understand how you fast the whole day. We have children and we have elders in our community who are able to do it. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Allah is showing us what we can do. Allah is showing us that His masajid, His houses, we can go to them if we want to. Because in this month, alhamdulillah, we have filled the masajid. We have filled the masajid with people. The MCC was blessed on Laylatul Qadr, or the 27th night of Ramadan, with over 1,600 people. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Expecting only about 1,000 or 1,200 people. The masajid now, they're built, and pretty soon they're beyond capacity. Masajid are being bought and built in America here, and pretty soon they need another masjid. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. These are the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but we have to remember that now that He has shown us what we are capable of doing, we have to carry this out through the rest of the year. We have shown ourselves that we can make the Quran central to our lives. We have gone to the masajid and we have listened to the Huffaz recite it from their hearts that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has put in their hearts when they memorized it. We have listened to the Quran. We have read the Quran. We have reflected on the Quran. Let us, brothers and sisters, for the rest of the year now, use that momentum to not take this Quran as something that we leave behind. One of the complaints that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam made to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala about his people Quraysh is that they took this Quran mahjura. They left it alone. They left it behind their backs. They ignored it. They didn't think about it. Because if they really listened to it with open ears and open hearts, and they were sincere, they would have benefited from it. And so let us not be from the people, Ya Rabbil Alameen, make us from the people who take this Quran as central to their lives and not take this Quran as mahjuran. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. I will end the first khutbah by reminding us that we have seen what we can do. We have seen our himmah, our aspirations and our capability. Let's use that momentum for the rest of the year. There were things in this month that made it easier, no doubt. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made certain things. He locked up the shayateen. He opened up the doors of Jannah. He closed the doors of Jahannam. And He sent multitudes of angels to the world. So no other month is going to be like Ramadan in terms of ease of ibadah. So all of those things were there. But we can replicate to a lesser degree some of those things. There are things that we can do in our life to reduce the shaytanic presence around us. There are things that we can do in our life to increase the angelic presence around us. There are things that we can do to open the doors of Jannah for us. Let us, brothers and sisters, use this momentum that we have from Ramadan for the rest of the year to use that and to keep that momentum going and to increase our tazkiyah and our purification of ourselves. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Alhamdulillah, wa salatu wa salamu ala Rasulillah. Walhamdulillah, ya Rabbil Alameen. Ya ibadullah, usikum wa usi nafsi bi taqwallah. Oh brothers and sisters, we praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and we send peace and blessings upon His noble messenger. And I encourage you and I encourage myself to have taqwa of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we will end with a reminder to us. I remind myself and remind others that even though this month was focused on ourselves, we also thought about others. We thought about others when we gave our zakah. We thought about others when we gave our sadaqah. We thought about others when we served people, such as the people who served today and didn't make it to the salah because they were serving in the parking lots, they were serving in the administration to facilitate it for us. There are people, brothers and sisters, behind the scenes at every masjid who didn't make it to all of the taraweeh, who weren't able to listen to all of the Quran. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless them for facilitating the ibadah for other people. But it's a reminder to us of service to other people. That even on this day, one of the main sunnah of this day, that's even stronger than the salah, and stronger of a sunnah than the clothes, and greeting other people and visit, is the sunnah of zakat al-fitr, of sadaqat al-fitr. This sadaqah that the Prophet ﷺ made as an obligation upon his community, what does it remind us? It reminds us that we have to think about others, especially on our days of joy. That we want the less fortunate to be able to enjoy this blessing by having food in their stomachs. And so it's a reminder to us, we have to think about other people. We have to think about serving other people. Muhammad Ali, the Wali of Allah, Rahmatullahi Alayhi, the boxer, one of his famous quotes was, service to humanity. Service to humanity is the rent we pay for our stay here on earth. Service to others is the rent we pay. So when we pay our zakat al-fitr, it's reminding Allah, you gave us this blessing, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. We're going to pay rent and help other people and not forget those less fortunate. We are blessed, brothers and sisters, here in the Bay Area. We are living in the top 3% of the economy of the entire world. We have one of the most richest economies in the world after the Gulf states. Additionally, maybe it was a dua of somebody that said, make it easy on the people of the Bay Area. Allahu Akbar. But didn't it make it easy for us? Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. I take that as something that I remind that Allah, when He gives you ease, when He gives us ease, He wants us to give to other people. He wants us to give to other people. One of the things that bothers me the most is when I look at the blessings that I have and we see on the news the people who all over the world don't even have the ability to do what we're doing here, the safety and the security to praise Allah, to join in congregation, to glorify Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And it bothers me so much that I've asked a number of people. I asked one of my students recently, Ahmed Adisan, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala free him from prison. He's innocent with life with parole in Missouri. I said, Ahmed, we have a lot of blessings. It makes me feel guilty when other people around the world don't have any. He said, brother, remember, we believe in the qadr of Allah. We believe in the ordainment of Allah. And those blessings that He gave you, that's from Allah. That's from the qadr of Allah that He gave you and didn't give to other people. But He gave that to you to make it easy for you so that you could help other people. So let's just take this month when we helped other people, and on this day when we gave out our sadaqah al-fitr to be distributed before or during this day to help other people. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us from the people who serve humanity and who serve the ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. To make us from the khuddam, from the servers. Ya Allah, make us from the people who serve you. Ya Allah, make us from the people who you have forgiven in this day and in this month. Ya Allah, make us from amongst the people who, when you have opened the doors to Jannah, those are the doors that you have made us, that you will make us enter from. Ya Allah, Ya Rabbil Alameen. Ya Allah, when you have closed the doors of Jahannam in this month, those are the doors that you have closed for us. Ya Allah, we ask you to purify us and to purify our sins and to purify and to give us the ability to continue in your worship and in your service and in the service of humanity. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Aqulu qawli hadha wa astaghfirullahu li wa lakum wa lisa'iril muslimin wal muslimat. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله.